11 years ago, the last one left the apartment. It was a really long-lasting tradition of the temperatore, which was always present in this building to control the clock maintenance. For more than 500 years, this clock there was habitated. If you are in the living room, they have the living room here. The living room with the view of the bed, but also with the view of the square. They had such a nice view. They live inside the clock mechanism, yeah. With the engine in the front door, with the clock mechanism, with the statues of the energy, with the... So the fifth mechanism, that mechanism put on the top, this is the mechanism of the digital clock. The two lateral mechanisms are the mechanisms of the Moors. Move the statues of the Moors. This is the mechanism of the right-hand Moor, view from the square. On the opposite side, you can see the mechanism of the left-hand one. Those two vertical cables go until the statues of the Moors, until the Moor style. As you can see from the Moors mechanism, until the statues. You must know that the Moors, they don't try the hours at the clock. They don't hit the bell at the clock. But 2 minutes before and 2 minutes after. So the right-hand Moor strikes the hours. 2 minutes before the exact hour, the left-hand one 2 minutes after. Lucia, in Luigi de Lucia put the fifth mechanism on the top of the Ferracina clock. The fifth mechanism is the wheel, the wheel of the hours in the Roman numerals, once in an hour, and the wheel of the minutes in Arabic figures, every 5 minutes. Every five, because there are only 12 panels, so that's why, just the 12 panels for 60 minutes, that's why it turns every five. As you can see, the digital clock took the place of the exit, passed exactly in the front of the Virgin, the angel who blows the trumpet, the eclipse, bowed, say hello, and come back by another door. So,
I mean, we have band-aids on our faces.
Yeah, as you can see, they have this. Take a look. What time is it? Just come closer.
Thank you. Thank you.